the Lord, for he is good. And his mercy endures forever. Amen and amen. Praise the Lord, Diane. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. My God from glory. I'm going to be bringing the scripture on today, and then we're going to go into prayer. Amen. We're coming from 2 Chronicles, the 20th chapter. Just reminded of a sermon my nephew preached, oh God, on Jehoshaphat, and it's just in my spirit. My God from glory. We're going to go to 2 Chronicles, the 2nd chapter and the 20th verse. And looks like we're going to try to read down to the 22nd verse. So 20, 21, and 22. And they rose early in the morning and went forth into the wilderness of Tekoa. And as they went forth, Jehoshaphat stood and said, "Hear me, O Judea, and ye inhabitants of Jerusalem. Believe in the Lord your God, so ye shall be established. Believe in his prophets, so shall ye prosper." And when he had consulted with the people, he appointed singers. We got some singers out here. Yeah. We got some singers out here. He appointed some singers. My God from glory. Thank you, Jesus. He appointed some singers, oh God, and they sung and they praised, oh God. That's what they did. Yeah. And that should praise the beauty of holiness as they went out before the army and said, "Praise the Lord, oh God." They said, "Praise the Lord, oh God." They said, "Praise the Lord, oh God. For his mercy endures forever." And when they began to sing, oh God, they began to sing the praises of the Lord set ambushes. I don't know if you need an ambush on today, but I need an ambush. I need somebody to help me. Oh Lord, I look to you to help me. I need an ambush, Jesus. My God from glory. He set an ambush against the children of Ammon and Moab and Mount Seir. And oh God, which were come against Judah. And they were smitten. As the story goes on, they tell me that they killed their own self. They turned on them own self. My God. God didn't even have to do nothing. I'm just here to let you know to stand still and see the salvation of the Lord. Let us pray. Father God, in the name of Jesus, we just thank you. Hallelujah, Jesus, God, for who you are. God, you are God Almighty and God all by yourself. Father God, we came back to tell you, thank you. Thank you for waking us up this morning. Thank you for closing us in our right mind. Thank you for the activities of our limb. Thank you for being so good, Jesus. Down through the years, he shall be good. God, and we came back to tell you, thank you. We thank you for the service on today. We gonna sing, Jesus, Abba Shina Messiah. Oh God, you're going to set up ambushes, oh God. You're going to set up ambushes, oh God. We praise you, oh God. We don't have to fight, oh God. But we can shout right now. We can shout right now. We can say right now. Hallelujah. We don't have to wait. Oh God, and we just thank you. Oh God, and we just praise you for what you're doing, oh God. Even in this United States of America, we praise you for what you're doing. We don't have to fight. We just gotta shout. We don't have to fight. We just gotta sing. In the name of Jesus, we'll do that. In Jesus' name, God bless you. Amen and amen.
Amen.
Come on, let me hear the horns blowing out there. Come on, let me see your hands clapping out there. Come on, let me hear a sound. A sound from Zion Church in Jesus Christ. Come on, let me hear a sound. Come on, blow them horns. Come on, lift those hands. Come on, clap those hands. To his name. Praise him. Let his glory rise among us. Come on. Come on, you can get out your car if you want to, but put your mask on.
Let's go.
Jesus. Not our glory, but His glory. That's on high, yet it lies among us. Hallelujah. The King of Kings, the Lord of Lords, came from heaven to earth to show us the way. And so we lift His name on high. Not just in the parking lot, but every day of our life, we're lifting His name. We let the world know that God is God, and He is in control of everything. Hallelujah, hallelujah, yes He is. Glory to Your name, Jesus.
We love you. God for being here this morning. I thank God for giving me another opportunity to stand before his people and to deliver his word. Amen. I truly do not take it for granted every opportunity that I get to deliver his word, to teach his word. Amen. It is an honor and a privilege, giving honor to God, the head of my life, giving honor to the pastor of this great church, Pastor Bobby Deary, and First Lady Nakia Deary, and to every elder, every minister, and even every layperson. I just shout hallelujah and praise God to you. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. I'm going to go ahead and not prolong this. I'm going to draw your attention to the scripture for today found in Joshua chapter 24. Verse number 14 through 16. If you'd like to follow along with me and join me in reading, you can. But if not, I'm just going to go ahead and read it in your hearing. Amen. Again, that's Joshua chapter 14, verses 14 through 16 and 26 through 27. Those of you that have the scriptures, shout amen out there if you have it.
Amen.
Let's read it together. Joshua 24, verse 14 says this. Now, therefore, fear the Lord and serve him in sincerity and in truth, and put away the gods which your fathers served on the other side of the flood and in Egypt, and serve ye the Lord. Verse 15 says, and if it seem evil unto you to serve the Lord, choose you this day whom ye will serve, whether the gods which your fathers served that were on the other side of the flood, or the gods of the Amorites in whose land ye dwell. But as for me and my house, we will serve the Lord. Verse 16 says this, and the people answered and said, God forbid that we should forsake the Lord to serve other gods. I'm going to skip down to verse number 26 and 27. It says thusly, and Joshua wrote these words in the book of the law of God, and took a great stone and set it up there under an oak that was by the sanctuary of the Lord. And Joshua said unto all the people, behold, this stone shall be a witness unto us, for it hath heard all the words of the Lord which he spake unto us. It shall be therefore a witness unto you, lest ye deny your God. And I'm going to read verse number 28. So Joshua let the people depart, every man unto his inheritance. Join me in prayer for 1 minute. Father God, in the name of Jesus, we thank you for this day. God, we thank you for your word that was just spoken. God, we ask you that you sanctify your word, that you purify your word, and let it go down deep into the hearts and souls and spirit of man, Lord God. Let them not only hear the word, but let them be doers of the word. In Jesus' name, we pray. Amen. 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 I'd like to speak real briefly from the topic, the crossover commitment.
All right.
The crossover commitment. Amen. Somebody just shout that text, that subject out. The crossover commitment.
The crossover commitment.
Amen. The year 2020 was supposed to be our year. I recall several preachers and churches declaring that the year 2020 would be a year of clear vision, that we would see the manifestation of God's glory in our lives. But none of us here in this parking lot visualized that we'd have a year like this. The past year was so filled with turmoil and destruction that it often felt like a nightmare that just wouldn't end. All of us looked forward to crossing over. We read social media posts of people expressing how anxious they were just to step into the new year and leave 2020 behind them. In fact, many of us were relieved when the clock struck midnight on December 31st and we were able to declare with gusto, I made it out and I made it out all right. And although we understood that the clock can't change our circumstances, we celebrated anyway because of what the clock symbolizes. The clock is a symbol of change. It's a symbol of a fresh start, a shift from night to morning, a change in season, the end of what was and the beginning of what was to come. But if we are honest with ourselves, none of us know what we're getting ready to face in 2021. Now, I'm praying and I'm hoping for good things. I'm hoping for prosperity. I'm hoping for healing. But we just don't know what 2021 is going to bring to us. But despite this uncertainty, we continue to walk by faith and believe that if God brought us over from 2020, that he is more than able and willing to bring us through 2021. one, no matter what we have to face or no matter what we have to deal with. So you can imagine the palpable sense of excitement that the children of Israel felt as they prepared to cross over the Jordan River and possess the promised land, a land that was flowing with milk and honey, a land of prosperity, a land that God ordained for them, a land that they could call their own. They were getting ready to finally see the manifestation of a centuries-old prophecy given to their father in the book of Genesis by the name of Abraham. They endured slavery and 40 years in the wilderness for this moment. They endured extreme heat, hunger, and thirst for this moment. They endured plagues and snake bites for this moment. And although many of the children of Israel did not make it because of their disobedience to God, the ones that were left still had a reason to celebrate. But there were also some feelings of apprehension. There were also some feelings of uncertainty. None of them had ever crossed over into new territory before. There were giants in this new land. The land was already inhabited by groups of people with large armies and fortified cities. It was a scary thing to cross over into the new land without having a full understanding of what they were getting ready to confront. But God assured Joshua to be strong and be of good courage, for as I was with Moses, so shall I be with thee. God requires us to cross over by faith. He may not give you all the details. He may not give you a roadmap. He may not show you everything that's getting ready to come your way, but he requires you just to move anyway, just to cross over anyway, to cross over afraid, cross over uncertain, cross over in fear, cross over anxious, cross over anyway. Somebody just shout out, cross over anyway. He just wants you to trust his word and his plan and keep on stepping towards your promise. The Israelites did as Joshua instructed them to do. They began to consecrate themselves for the crossover. They began to sanctify themselves for the crossover. He told the priests to take up the ark, representing the power and the presence of God, and to stand before the people. The Bible says that as the priests stepped toward the brim of the Jordan River, the waters began to divide into a heap, allowing the children of Israel to cross over on dry land, just as he allowed the children of Israel to cross over the Red Sea on dry land. The priests stood in the middle of the Jordan until everybody crossed over. They stood in the middle of the Jordan holding the Ark of the Covenant, holding the heavy ark with its gold. They stood in the midst of the Jordan. I'm sure they got weak holding up that ark, but they had to wait for everybody to cross over. Their grip got a little shaky at times because they were losing strength, but God told them to wait until everybody crossed over. They could not drop the ark so that they could rest. They could not set the ark down and take a 15-minute break. They had a responsibility to the people of God to hold on to what God gave them in order to ensure that a generation of people could cross over into the other side. Lord have mercy. You see, sometimes the weight of glory that is on your life, it gets exhausting. It gets tiring. Sometimes you get weary and tired while carrying the anointing of God. It seems like everybody else is benefiting off of your anointing. Everybody else is receiving a blessing. Everybody else is getting healed. Everybody else is getting saved. Everybody else is being delivered. All the while, you're still stuck in the middle of the Jordan. Sometimes you just want to take a break. Sometimes you just want to lie down. Sometimes you don't want to be a minister today. Sometimes you don't want to be an elder today. You don't want to be an evangelist. You don't want people calling you, asking you for prayer because you're in the need of prayer. Sometimes you don't want that role. You don't want that responsibility. But God wanted me to tell you that you cannot set your anointing down just because you're tired. You cannot let your standards down just because you're weak. But you've got to hold on to what I've given you. And while you're holding on, while you're hanging on in there, while you're holding up the bloodstained banner of the Lord, while you're preaching, while you're teaching Bible study, while you're teaching Sunday school, God said he's going to supply you with strength. He's going to supply you with power until he's able to relieve your burden. Somebody shout amen. God then commands Joshua to have one man from each tribe to gather a stone out of the midst of the riverbed and to set it up as a memorial in a place called Gilgal as a sign to future generations of the wonder that God performed at the Jordan River. So when their children asked them one day about the stones, the Israelites would be able to tell them about what God brought them through. I hope that while you were enduring the pandemic, that you picked up a few stones along the way. I hope that while you were going through the pandemic, that you picked up a testimony or two while you were crossing over the Jordan. I hope you didn't just cross and not pick up no stones. Those stones represent your testimony. Those stones represent the times that God brought you out. I can't wait for the day when I'll be able to tell my future unborn children about how God brought me over, about how God sustained my family. This stone represents how he healed me. This stone represents how he saved me from the pandemic. This stone represents how he gave me a house in the middle of the pandemic. This stone represents how he kept my mind stable and gave me peace and comfort. This stone that you see right here represents my family and how they were kept safe. This stone right here represents how I was able to keep my job during 2020 while everybody else was laid off and everybody else got cuts and everybody else had to find a new job. God kept me. God restored me. Somebody out there shout, I got some stones too. I got some stones too. Let me show you my stones. Let me show you what God brought me out of. Let me show you what God brought me through. Let me show you how God delivered me. Let me show you how God set me free. After crossing over the Jordan River, the next obstacle to overcome was Jericho. We all know the story of Jericho. The Israelites were commanded to march around the wall for 6 days, one time for 6 days, and seven times on the seventh day. The Bible says that after the children of Israel marched, that the priests blew their trumpets, and the children of Israel began to open up their mouth and shout. And as they shouted, the Bible says that the walls of Jericho fell flat. It didn't say that the walls of Jericho crumbled. It didn't say that the walls of Jericho just began to dissolve. It said it fell flat. It went from one position down to the next position. Hallelujah. As they began to shout, God gave them the victory. And the Israelites began to pillage the city, slaughtering all the inhabitants of Jericho and taking away their possessions. Only the prostitute Rahab and her family were spared because she protected the Israelite spies. I came to tell each and every person in this parking lot, the only reason why you're still here today, the only reason why you're still alive is because the blood was covering you. I know you think it was the mask that you got on right now, right? You think it was the hand sanitizer. You think it was the gloves. You think it was because of the hospital visit. But no, baby, you are spared today because of the blood of Jesus. I just believe that I've come into contact with the coronavirus in 2020 because I ain't been that careful not to come in contact with it. But even when I came in contact with it, the blood of Jesus stepped in between me and death and said, don't touch my child. Oh, you gotta give God some praise because the blood stepped in between you and death. The blood stepped in between you and harm. The blood stepped in between you and disease. The blood stepped in between you and sickness. You ought to give God some praise. I'm almost finished, y'all. As you begin to read through the book of Joshua, you'll find that God continued to keep and protect the children of Israel. They captured the city of Ai. They destroyed the Ammonites. They slayed the prophet Balaam that was commissioned by King Balak to curse them. They defeated Jabin's alliance of kings that came against them. The Bible says that in total, Joshua defeated 31 kings. The Israelites defeated every obstacle that they faced. Every king that came against them, they destroyed. And every battle that they fought, God gave them the victory. And so now, after the land has been possessed and divided among the Israelite tribes, Joshua is getting ready to transition. Joshua is getting ready to pass away. He gathers the people together and he begins to remind them of all that the Lord did for them. How he called Abraham from his country and his kin into the land of Canaan. How he delivered his people from slavery and bondage through the Red Sea. How he carried them through the wilderness for 40 years. How he defended them against the Amorites and the wicked King Balak and the false prophets. prophet Balaam, how he allowed them to cross over Jordan and overcome Jericho and its inhabitants, how he gave them a land that they did not work for, cities that they did not build, vineyards that they did not plant. Then Joshua tells the people, choose ye this day whom ye will serve. Now this seems like a strange saying, Cousin Candy. It would appear that the Israelites had already made their choice. They've been following Joshua this whole time. They've been serving the Lord this whole time. So why would he say, choose ye this day whom ye will serve? That's when I realized that Joshua was trying to get the Israelites to solidify their commitment to God because of their ability to cross over the Jordan River. They still had some stuff that they were still hanging on to. They still had some strange idols. They still had some strange beliefs. They still had some strange practices. And so Joshua was trying to tell them, you need to let all of that go and completely commit to God. Completely surrender to God. Surrender your time. Surrender your gifts. Surrender your money. Surrender your possessions. Surrender your mind to the will and the purpose of God. Get rid of everything that you're holding on to and give God your all. The children opened up their mouths and they began to make a vow that they would serve the Lord only. To establish their vow, Joshua wrote down their words. He took a stone and he placed it under an oak tree as a witness to them all of their vow. And God is saying the same exact thing to us. I protected you and your family in the midst of the pandemic. I sustained your health. I kept you out of the hospital. I let you keep your job. I blessed your finances and made sure your bills were paid on time. I protected your children and kept them in virtual school. I kept your church going. I kept your ministry going. I let your business flourish. I bought you houses and cars and land in the middle of the pandemic. I gave you promotions and increase. I let you find a new job. Now I need something from you in exchange. I need you to tell me yes. I know you've been saying yes to the Lord all your life, but God is saying, I need another level of commitment from you. I need you to tell me yes. This year, I need you to tell me yes to your calling. This year, you will not deny that you are a preacher. This year, you will not deny that you are a teacher. This year, you will do exactly what the Lord called you to do. Or else, if you don't do it, there are no guarantees that I'm keeping you in 2021. I know that's a hard word to hear. I know that's difficult for y'all to hear. It was difficult for me to hear because it caused me to think about my own life, think about my own relationship with God, the things I need to let go, the things that I need to put on. The Bible says lay aside every weight and the sin that does so easily beset you. This year, you will not use COVID as an excuse to not continue your ministry. This year, you're going to do what I called you to do. This year, you're going to go where I called you to go. This year, you better say what I called you to say. This year, you better preach what I called you to preach. This year, you better do what I called you to do. This year, you better go where I called you to go. This year, you better do what I called you to do. This year, you better go where I called you to go. This year, you better do what I called you to do. This year, you cannot use COVID as an excuse. This year, you cannot use sickness as an excuse. This year, you cannot use social distancing as an excuse. But you've got to use what I gave you. You've got to hold on to the ark. You got to hold on to the presence of God. You got to hold on to the power I gave you. You can't sit it down. You can't let it go. You can't forget about it. You can't let go of your responsibility. You can't walk away from your calling. You can't walk away from your purpose. You can't walk away from what I told you to do. But you got to open up your mouth and shout yes. Somebody open up your mouth and shout yes, Lord. No, I need a real yes. I said open up your mouth and shout yes, Lord. Yes, Lord, I'll go. Yes, Lord, I'll do. Yes, Lord, I'll say. Yes, Lord, I'll be. I'll lay aside every sin. I'll lay aside every weight. I'll fully commit to you. I'll fully honor myself to you. I'll fully dedicate myself to you. Somebody open up your mouth and shout yes. Come on. Come on, begin to open up your mouth and lift up your hands. And shout, Lord, I'll tell you yes. I'll tell you yes this time, for real. I know I've been praying, but I'll tell you yes this time, for real. I'll tell you yes this time, for real.
If you need to be saved, then I suggest you get saved today. I suggest you get saved today. Don't hold off. Don't wait, because you don't know where you're going to be tomorrow. God is serious about 2021. And if you're not going to do what he says, he has no purpose to keep you. He has no reason to keep you around if you're not going to do what he told you to do. Come on, keep telling the Lord yes until you feel it in your spirit. Until you feel it in your belly. Keep telling the Lord yes until you feel something break in your spirit. Keep telling the Lord yes until you feel it in your soul. Yeah, come on, come on, come on. I know it's hard. I know it's difficult. I know all of that. I know all of that. But tell them yes anyway. Tell them yes afraid. Tell them yes uncertain. Tell them yes fear.
God wants a yes. I said, God wants a yes. God wants a real yes. Not a half-hearted yes. Not a yes, maybe sometimes I do it, maybe when I feel like it, maybe. No. God wants another level of yes this year. Another level of yes this year. I know you've been telling him yes all your life, but another level of yes this year. He's requiring more blood. He's requiring more sacrifice. He wants more out of you. I don't care how young you are. I don't care how old you are. He's requiring more of you this year. This year. Somebody just lift up your hands and just begin to tell the Lord yes. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. From the bottom of my heart to the depths of my soul, yes, Lord, completely, yes, my soul. This time for real, says yes. Come on, everybody, sing with me. Yes, Lord. Come on. Say my soul. Come on, one time. Say yes, Lord. Everybody say yes, Lord. Come on and sing. Yes, Lord. From the bottom of my heart to the depths of my soul. My soul, my soul, my soul. your word today. God, we thank you, Lord God, for speaking to us. God, we thank you for allowing us to cross over from 2020 to 2021. God, we thank you, God, for giving us another chance because millions did not make it. So many people passed in 2020, but God, you saw fit that we would be here today. But the only reason why you've kept us alive is because we still have purpose and the urge to fulfill. The only reason why you've kept us here is because you're requiring another yes from us. So God, help us, Lord God, to open up our mouths and say, yes, Lord, despite the circumstances, despite the issues that we have to face in 2021, despite the losses, Lord God, in 2021, help us to still open up our mouths and say yes. Help us to make a commitment to you from this day forward that we'll do what you say, that we'll do what you've called us to do. And Father, we'll forever give you all the glory and honor and praise that is due your name. And everybody, open up your mouth and shout amen. Amen. God bless you, everybody.